Let's look at why we have clips on shoes and how we put clips on shoes.
Putting a clip on a shoe in many ways is as useful, maybe more useful, than adding additional nail holes to a shoe. And a clip can do a number of things to help you be more successful keeping shoes on horses' hooves. First off, a clip will support a weak hoof wall. It'll also reduce the twisting forces on the nails depending on the amount of traction that the shoe develops with the ground. A clip or clips can prevent a shoe being driven backwards on a hoof. And also clips will reduce the size or the number of nails that you'll need to keep shoes securely on hooves. And then, especially in therapeutic situations, clips can constrain unwanted movement of hoof wall, for example, a fractured coffin bone.
The criteria for a quality clip are the following. They have to be strong. They need to be large enough to do the job intended. They need to taper from the base, which will be stronger and thicker, to a thinner tip, but the tip cannot be so fine that it would cause injury to the horse. The tip should be rounded. Ideally, a clip should be an equal-sided triangle, at least, with the height being equal to the base. And on the inside of the clip, on the foot surface of the shoe, there shouldn't be any alteration causing pressure to the sole.
There are two distinct steps to making a clip. The first one is to create a bubble from the side of the outer edge of the shoe, and the second one then is to create the clip from that bubble. The key to making consistent quality clips is to create the largest bubble possible with the minimum amount of distortion to the shoe. Creating the correct sized bubble with the minimum amount of distortion to the shoe can then be broken down into distinct steps. We begin with pushing the steel out from the side of the shoe and then pushing the steel down into the hardy hole, turning the shoe over, flattening everything that you do not want to be involved in the bubble, so you confine either side of the bubble, then move the shoe to the right hand side of the anvil face so that the bubble hangs over the edge of the anvil, and begin the clip down the side of the anvil. To begin, what you want to do is practice making consistent bubbles in a variety of shoes, and then you'll be more successful making consistent clips.